I'm Cameron. I like stuff. I want to talk to you about it. Today, another Obsidian plugin that is, it's called Continuous Mode. This is a plugin that emulates something that's available in the program Scrivener, which is a writing program for all types of writing, really. Let me show you what Scrivener does. And then we'll go back to Obsidian and we'll take a look at what this plugin does. And we'll give a brief overview and comparison and see what's what. So this is Scrivener. As you can see, I've got a free trial to test it out. It is $60 USD, Windows and Mac. The way that the free trial works is it only counts down if you actually open the program. I've been on 25 days for a while now. And then tomorrow, if I open it again, it'll be 24. If I don't open it up again tomorrow, whenever I do open it up again, it'll be 24. So if you don't open up the program and don't use it, trial doesn't go down. You get 30 days of actual use out of it, no matter how long that 30 days takes. So this is the kind of main UI. It, by default, kind of works in a way that's like folder notes in Obsidian, where every thing that's a folder, they're called binders here, is also a note in itself with subnotes. And then you can see that you've got different views. So this will be just a list of stuff in there, an alternate kind of file explorer you can see. You can do little note cards, type on them. And then you've got this thing right here, which is called Scrivenings mode. So let's look at the list of stuff that's in this paperback binder. Title page, copyright, dedication, blank page, chapter one, chapter two. Let's open up one of them. We've got a project title there, author. Presumably these are variables to be filled in through like settings or something like that for the project. So copyright, so just the copyright, nothing else, dedication. So yeah. We got some hefty, very dense, genuine English language words here. The Scrivenings one, as you can see, we've got that title page here. Then we got that copyright right there. Dedication. We got the blank page. And then we got that genuine English words right here. And then chapter two. So as you can see, what this one does is this view. Is it takes everything that's in this binder and it just puts it into a view that is a free-flowing, continuous, one after the other view of the whole binder. This is something that some stuff in Obsidian can do. The Longform plugin can do it. Make.md is a plugin that I think has a very similar function. I've used both. A little bit, not too extensively. They don't really fit in with how I like to work, but that's what the Scrivenings mode is. It's something I've seen it recommended. There's like a few feature request threads and stuff on the Obsidian forums about it. So let's go back to Obsidian, Continuous Mode, Michael Schrauser. There will be a link down there to the GitHub. And let's just take a quick look. Obsidian Continuous Mode. An Obsidian plugin that displays all open notes in a tab group as if they were a single continuous document, sometimes called Scrivenings mode. It seems to function a little differently from how Scrivener actually did. Let's install this puppy. Let's enable this puppy. What's, no settings. Okay, no settings it looks like. We've got our sandbox vault that we've been doing. Let's go to, but I only have one note open. So what it said was it takes the notes that were open. Okay, it looks like we're doing it. So plugins make Obsidian special for you. Let's scroll down. We've got the backlinks here. I wonder if you'd want to turn those on or if you want to turn those off. I guess that makes sense. I mean, I guess it doesn't matter. Just whatever you want, I guess, but interesting. And just scroll down. We got the next one right there. Block quote, block quote, so call out will be after. We got call out right there. So, oh yeah, that's kind of neat. Just scroll there. So, obviously there's some differences that we can easily note. For one, in Scrivener, it's going to automatically do whatever's in that binder or that folder or whatever. And this one, you have to set it up yourself. So it doesn't seem like you can, I mean, I guess you can maybe get a plugin or something so you can right click and open up all the notes in a folder and then turn in the continuous mode. Yeah, and you can drag the tabs to reorder them in the continuous mode. That doesn't change anything about where they are. So I feel like these are pretty different use cases. There's a little bit more customizability with this because you don't, you aren't forced to open up all the stuff that's in a single folder. You can open up whichever notes you want from wherever in your vault. So that's very cool. All right, so there's continuous mode in the context menu. So let's go to comment. We'll scroll down. And there should be PDF. Yeah, just right there. Is this every page? It looks like it's just every page of the PDF. So I hit the down arrow and I went to the footnote, which is below the PDF. And then the right and left arrows will scroll between the pages of the PDF. But if I hit down or up, I'll go, okay. It's a little unintuitive, a little clunky, but it's there. So if you ever want to create a video game with Pico 8, there's a number of resources out there you can look for. The ability to have an endless view where you can scroll up and down and jump between what are actually individual notes, fantastic. I haven't found an implementation that works for me yet. I'm a messy person. I'm a messy creative person. When I'm working on something, It's not an organized thing. So in that sense, I think maybe the continuous mode is really nice because you don't have to have everything all together. And you can, even if they are all bunched up in one single folder, you know, there might be subfolders and you can pick and choose from there. And you have the ability to exclude them. So sure, there's 6 files or whatever, all in one folder. But maybe you just want 2 or 3 of them to be in that mode. So you can just easily flick through them. And you can do that with here. I don't think you can do the Scrivener unless you are going to be temporarily moving files out of those folders. So this is pretty nice. I guess if I needed something, I would probably want it to omit the backlinks in the continuous mode, or at least an option for it. Because I like to have the backlinks at the bottom of the document throughout my vault, just in general. But in continuous mode, I probably wouldn't want that. But I also wouldn't want to have to, like, click through and turn it off. I would probably just keep them displayed on there, even though it would probably bother me. It's not bad. It's very straightforward. No options. You know, you get what you get. I think it works out nicely. And then, you know, maybe a way to, I don't know, condense this into a special tab or something. But that's kind of nitpicky, you know. No complaints. If you're someone that's used Scrivener and this is something that you're missing, I think it's definitely worth a shot. If you haven't used Scrivener and so you don't really have, like, you know, a preconceived, like, idea or want or desire for something like this, does it look like something you might use? There's certain instances where I could see myself with, you know, a split pane, 2 panes, right side, left side, and both of them have a continuous mode with different notes going on. You know, I could see that happening, definitely. There you go. Continuous mode, Obsidian plugin. Go try it out. Or don't. Follow your heart. It's fine either way. See ya.